you're saying the opposite of that would be you're setting it with the government department, which is under HHS, and notoriously was part of the bureaucracy that oversaw child separation, that they are essentially just allowing these children to languish in these facilities.
Wait, and I don't want to say that they're allowing them to languish, because that's not precisely, I think, the dynamic that we're seeing here. What we're seeing is massive mismanagement of this department and a tremendous impact on it. So that, for example, right now, many of these children are being put, when they are in a lot of countries, these placements at places like Homestead and the Walmart, which I visited, that the Tony of Kent City, when that was open, which I also inspected, and these facilities cost about $750 per day per child. That is what we pay to put a child in the rich college. These are not the scholarships. And to make it worse, these kids are being kept there not for the 20 days that they're allowed to be kept by law, but rather for 5, 6, 7, we interview children who have been in any facility for longer than 9 months at this cost. And if you do the analysis, Chris, you'll find out that you can save the taxpayers $1 billion a year simply by taking the children who have families here in the United States, who have parents in the United States, and placing them with those parents.
All right, thank you so much for sharing that.
You're welcome. Thank you.
I want to bring in Congressman Michael Burgess, a Republican of Texas. Congressman, I guess a first question is that I would imagine you and your colleagues agree that these kinds of conditions are appalling and unacceptable.
Well, certainly in my experience, I've visited all our own MCPP facilities on a lot of occasions, as recently as 3 weeks ago down in McAllen. I'm going again this Friday, so I've made a lot of effort to spend time on the ground. What I will tell you is the conditions I saw in McAllen at the Customs Border Patrol facility 3 weeks ago, right at the end of May, they've always been tough down there. It's tougher than it's ever been because of the numbers of people that are coming across. And when they are picked up, yes, they do go to a Customs Border Patrol facility. That is what we charge our men and women who work for Customs Border Patrol. That's what we charge them with doing. And I will also say I do make a little bit of exception to people who denigrate the reason we were a hero, there were four people found, a mother and three children found deceased in a family mission, Texas, according to the AP. I don't know what the cause of that was. It didn't appear to be homicidal violence. Presumably, they died because of weather conditions. These are the types of people the Customs Border Patrol picks up and rescues on a daily basis, hundreds every day.
Sure.
And those facilities, yes, they are. They strain. In fact, Chief Farzell, when I was down there last, said, well, you know, I've got to take off the line to send down the wildlife to buy weapons. They are doing their level best.
What
Congress needs to do is appropriate money during ORR so that they can take those children and buy it like that fashion. But I just want to say the question, and obviously it's something you have devoted time and attention to, and I know it's something that really comes to your heart. Just for that, you and I agree. I will tell you that I started going down there in 2014. and along with sending kids off to who knows where. No one called to check on the child after they got there. There was no follow-up. It's very, very intrusive of all the social workers. Nobody should ask you to ask you. You're asking your very personal. And there's a question. What is the ideal situation? What is the question? The ideal situation, from a policy perspective, you would agree, is if they have a family member in the state that they can go to, for the U.S. government not to stretch its resources and have to look after them and sit them with those folks. Someone needs to check. Look, I was in another period where they also think they shouldn't live. October 2015, I heard from a network of people who were trapped by family members.